We'll take a look at the new capabilities in Microsoft Teams that can help you in your day-to-day, and you can use those to transform your workplace collaboration and streamline your business processes. Now, we're going to show you some new capabilities for chat, collaboration, meetings, and file sharing, as well as new private conversations for scoped conversations with specific team members in a team, plus improved integration with Microsoft 365 apps like OneDrive, Outlook, and much more. So here to join us and show us how, I'm joined by Aya Tange from Teams. Big round of applause.
It's great to be back on the show, Jeremy.
Thank you. So we've seen huge momentum with Microsoft Teams over the last year. But for those who are new to Teams, why don't we recap the core experiences?
Sure. So the uptake has been amazing. We now have over 500,000 organizations using Teams and 13 million daily active users. But the real appeal here is as you work with your teams, you have everything that you need in a single and secure location. So you have your chat so you can communicate quickly with your teams. You have meetings so you can connect seamlessly with video and screen sharing. You have calling so you can unify everything into one place. And of course, we give you those integrated app experiences, not just with the familiar Office apps, but with your line of business apps, third-party apps, and services as well. And of course, with all this comes your enterprise-grade security and compliance that you'd expect with the Microsoft 365 suite.
And of course, if you want a deeper primer on all of this using Microsoft Teams, you're going to want to check out Aya's previous show at aka.ms/guide-to-teams. Also, before we show all the newest updates, just to bring everyone up to speed, in the past few weeks, we've introduced some really cool stuff, like chat translation, so you can actually chat into multiple languages and translate those chats for multiple languages. Customized backgrounds. This is one of the things I recorded earlier this week during video calls. I can pretend I'm in different places. Also, industry-specific features. So we've got things like shifts for first-line workers that we can use for scheduling and getting all of that work done. Also, priority notifications. This is great for things like healthcare, where you'd have to have kind of these priority notifications land on your mobile device. And these are just a couple of my favorite things.
And those are actually great ones to call out because they truly reflect your feedback. So thank you so much to everyone who's been on this journey with us. It's been quite an exciting time.
All right, but I think now's the time to walk through the brand new stuff. It's been pretty consistent on the left rail, for example, on
sure.
Microsoft Teams. But I can see you've got a couple of new items here that no one else probably here, including myself, have.
Yes, so let's start from the top. So we've got Activity, Chat, Teams, Calendar, Calls, Files, and now Yammer, and even a Power App pinned to the left rail, which I'll talk about in a little bit. But let's start with chat, as this is one of our core experiences. The first capability speaks to the work that we're doing to make it easier for you to communicate with others. So I know you're probably all talking to a lot of different people, and you have many chats coming in. And in the past, you have to go into each chat and engage one-to-one. But now with our new multi-window functionality, I can pop out the chats and work across multiple at the same time.
All right, you can clap for that. I've been wanting that as well.
That's an exciting one.
All right, so that's a feature I know a lot of people have been waiting to see because they can hear it from the applause alone. There's a lot more though, right?
Yes, let me show you a couple other. So soon you'll actually be able to notify a specific subset of people right within a team or channel. So let me go into my launch event channel and I'm going to at mention the logistics team. And those who have the logistics tag will get the notification. Of course, anyone can see that post in my team, but only those with the tag will get that at mention. So let me show you where you can see all these tags. I can click on the ellipses, hit manage teams, and owners can create the tags while members can actually use them. And all the tags are on the right-hand side.
And it's a great way in terms of scoping those communications, especially in larger teams, so you don't have to tag everybody individually like you would have had to do last week.
Exactly, it's a lot more efficient. But another time saver we're introducing is the ability to actually share the same post in multiple teams and channels. And this is what we call cross-channel posting.
Right.
So I can click on this button here and select the channels I want this to go into. So I want to include general. And now when I send this off, it'll go to both locations. But I also want to make sure that these posts stand out more than the rest without having to resort to font treatment or using all caps.
And nobody likes all caps
no,
or the caps lock
No, we don't
key.
Like those. So let's use the new announcement capability. So now I have a headline. So I'll say event time change. So I have this headline. I've got the colored background. I even can put an image behind it as well. But this is all to catch people's eyes.
Awesome. So this is going to save the shift keys, the control C, and the control V keys as well. Really great seeing all that integration, but I know that we've also got some Yammer integration that we've built in for broader cross-org communication. So in addition to the all caps or some of the formatting we saw there, letting you announce things from the rooftops using Yammer.
Yes, we do. We have a complete Yammer experience right within Teams. So now I can share an idea, ask a question, like things, comment things, just like I would do in Yammer. But what I love about this is I can now keep a pulse on what's happening in the organization without toggling between apps.
These are really great ways to kind of keep everyone up to date. But why don't we switch gears, though, and talk about the other side of the spectrum, or maybe you don't want everybody to be up to date with all the things that you're talking about and not communicate quite as broadly.
Sure. We have a much-requested capability that I'm excited to announce is generally available this week, and that is private channels.
All right.
So private channels are actually indicated by a lock that you see right here, but they're really easy to create. So I can add a channel here, and now I have a two privacy settings. I've got standard, so accessible to everyone on the team, or private, accessible to a specific group, let's say your leadership team.
This is great. You don't have to create additional teams, and also when you've got a team with a lot of people in it, you can have these parallel conversations, like you mentioned, on a leadership team, maybe a project team, to where not everyone needs to be privy to it.
Exactly. And to keep you organized, just like you do in chat, you can now pin channels to the top of your teams. So I work out of this launch event channel frequently, so I'm going to click on the ellipses and hit pin, and now it'll be easily accessible right at the top.
Awesome. So we got files here. Is there anything new on the file side?
Yes. So Yammer isn't the only integrated experience that we have. I know a lot of you are coming from the SharePoint world, and so we've improved that integration so you have that rich, familiar SharePoint files experience right within Teams. We also have the sync button here up at the top where you can sync your files back to your desktop. But we also want to make sure that sharing's easy as well. So I want to share this Word document right here. I'm going to go ahead and copy that link. Now, when I go into chat, I want to paste it. When I paste it, you'll see that I have a sharing dialog in line. Now I can share with people currently in this chat and decide if they get editing or viewing access.
This is great. This is something I personally was asking the SharePoint team and the team's engineering teams for. Great to see it in the product.
Yes, you got it. And now coming soon, we will also have tasks in Teams. So now I have my personal tasks here. You can see things that I need to get done, and this is for my eyes only. I can see those that are assigned to me, as well as Teams tasks, which are created at a channel level. And I've got a couple other views, too. So I've got my board, so I can see what's coming up, what I need to get done. I have my charts, so I can see my progress and my status, as well as a schedule, so I can see everything in a calendar view. And this is all powered by To-Do and Planner.
Great to see that integration. You can clap for that one, too. That's awesome. I know a ton of people are big fans of Planner and To-Do. Great to see that new integration.
Yes, and let me show you one more thing, because I know this one will be exciting. So a lot of you are probably toggling between Outlook and Teams on a regular basis, and we want to make sure that you can easily flow conversations between the two. So let me go to my Outlook here, and I want to share this email into Teams. Now, in the top right-hand corner, you have a Share to Teams button. I can click on that, and I want to share this to my design team, and I can hit Share. So let's see what this looks like in Teams. Now, my manager has actually sent in a couple emails already that we've been working on. It even includes attachments, so I can hit that with just one touch. But you can see we're already collaborating on those action items that we need to get done.
Very cool. Full fidelity with attachments and the Teams file experience there. But can I also send it the other way around from Teams back into Outlook?
Yes, you can. So now let's say I want to share this post here. I'm going to click on the ellipses, share to Outlook. And now I can send that to a broader audience.
Nice. It's great to see the bridging of the two worlds of Outlook, in this case, in Teams. But now we've covered quite a few things. We've covered chat, Teams channels, apps, files, also the integration we saw there with Outlook. What about meetings? I think we've done a bit there as well, right?
Yes. I know we all spend a lot of time in meetings. So let's start with creating a new meeting. So I need to meet with my colleague, Alan, here for a one-to-one. Now, at the top, I have a scheduling assistant, probably something you're familiar with Outlook, but we're bringing it into Teams so that now you can easily find time with your colleagues. So now I can send this off. But your Outlook calendar and your Teams calendar are identical, so any changes you make in Teams will show up in Outlook and vice versa. But why don't we go ahead and join this meeting here?
Okay, I've done that just a second ago.
There we go. And so now we want to make sure that meetings are inclusive for everyone. And so we've already added closed captions and transcription services in our recorded meetings in Stream. But now, while you're in the meeting, you can turn on live captions.
Very cool. And due to the kind of the ambient noise that we've got here, it's a little bit difficult to show that. So I'm going to go back to my machine, and I'll show you what that looks like actually running. So here we can see a transcribed meeting.
Yes, and we've actually built this feature for those who are hard of hearing or have different levels of language proficiency. But I've actually found myself turning this on by default so that I can stay more engaged in the conversation.
So it's really useful, but beyond voice-to-text capabilities in meetings for visual communications, we've also added the whiteboard as well.
Yes. Right? So now when I open my share tray here, I now have access to my Microsoft whiteboard. And so we've added this so that regardless of where you are, you have a virtual whiteboard to collaborate on with your team. And this is now generally available.
This is great. I'm going to use this, I think, in all of my remote meetings, especially when we're drawing out architectures and things.
Yes. But it gets even better. You can now actually share your analog meeting room whiteboards right within Teams. So in this video that you're about to see, the room has a dedicated whiteboard camera where, using AI, it finds a physical whiteboard, brings the image into focus, and even makes the ink more legible for the people online, but also detects people and makes them transparent. So when someone walks in front of it, the people online can see right through them.
Awesome. So you can collaborate then even using analog whiteboards in this case. It's going to really make the meeting experience really cool. But going back to that, you popped out chat earlier.
Yes.
And I bet people want to be able to pop out their meeting windows as well. Can we do that too?
Yes, you can. So now here I have this button that I can pop out the meeting. And now it'll open up into another window. And I still have access to the rest of my team's platform.
Awesome.
That's a one. I know that's one that people are going to be using.
So a lot of updates to the core experiences. But last time you were on Mechanics, you showed us something really cool. How you can build out these automated custom experiences for teams, like building approval workflows or apps. Now, if you missed that, you can actually check that out at aka.ms/teamspower on the Microsoft Mechanics channel. Is there anything new in this space?
Sure. Any Power App users in the room?
Power Apps?
Oh, yeah, I see
all
a couple.
Right.
That's awesome.
We need more, though.
We need more. So for those who are new to Power Apps, the low-code development tool that helps you create apps to do things such as track and update budgets, estimate costs, and even manage employee time off. So here, I'm in my Power App that I've recently created that looks at process returns. But I've actually used our new AI Builder capabilities, where I can now take a picture of something, and it'll automatically detect it and populate all the information that I need.
That's amazing, because I would have guessed that was a Mark 6 or maybe a 7.
I know, but it's a Mark 8.
Yes, of course.
But I didn't need to know any coding or any machine learning models. So we also want to make sure that you have easy access to your Power Apps. So you can pin your apps to the left rail now, so that regardless of where you are, you always know where to find them. So I know this all sounds really advanced, but you can work up to it. We have some great Power App templates that I recommend you check out.
So lots of great updates to the core experiences, I think, for low-code customization. But for everything that we saw here with Microsoft Teams, where can people go to learn more?
Sure. So we already have some great team shows on Microsoft Mechanics. So you can visit aka.ms/teamsmechanics. But you can also go to our one-stop shop at aka.ms/successwithteams. And this is our place where you can find both technical and end-user documentation.
All right, so hopefully everyone here is as inspired as I am to use Microsoft Teams in your daily work. And of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates across Teams and much more. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.